The seating control strategy on Atlas Copco controllers is specialized for joints with increased rundown friction, such as thread-cutting screws, or joints with side loads for misaligned parts. The strategy will detect the screw seating and compensate the rundown torque and friction to install the same clamp torque for every screw. Floating screws are eliminated, while thread stripping and broken parts can be detected and reported to the operator. Let's take a look at how the Pset is set up in ToolsTalk MT. Here's our seating control strategy Pset. It's a two-step Pset. The first step is a thread engagement step. This is designed to help the screws start to thread into the surface of the joint. The second step is the seating control setup. Here we set our speed, and we set our final tightening method. We could either control it to stop at a certain torque point or at a certain angle. I'm going to do torque, and I want our desired clamp torque to be about 5 centinewton meters. The seating angle displacement will be 180, with the gradient trigger point being 75. These two values are going to be what will allow the algorithm to detect when the seating has occurred by how fast the gradient ramps back up. We'll see what this looks like when we use the trace viewer later. We could also set minimum torque and maximum torque values for the entire tightening. If we do have a maximum torque load that we do not want to exceed, we could prevent the tool from doing that by entering it here. We could also set minimum clamp torque and maximum clamp torque to have the Pset fail or not. I'll set the minimum clamp torque at, say, 3. And we'll set the maximum clamp torque at 8. So we're aiming for that clamp torque of 5, but now I'm going to set limits so that the Pset will fail if we don't hit that. We can also do the same for angle, but I'll leave that at the default setting. Once we're all done, we'll save our settings. Make sure we activate it on the controller. On the controller, I'm going to navigate over to my custom view, where I have our peak torque, our total angle, the seating point, and the clamp torque. Now for this Pset, it's only going to care about reaching our desired clamp torque of 5 centinewton meters. It's not going to care if the peak torque is at 10 or at 8. That doesn't matter right now. So you can see our first one, we reached our clamp torque of 5 centinewton meters and our seating torque at 4.16. The peak torque was 9, but that's going to change from joint to joint. I'll open up our trace viewer on screen here, so we can have a look at what's going on. Here we could see that gradient ramp up where it detected the seating point. So this has to happen within a certain time and value. We'll do a tutorial and get more in depth about how to set that value. Here we can see our clamp force was 5.027 centinewton meters, right on target. So let's now change to a size hole that is slightly smaller than the holes that we're working on now. So now we should experience the same clamp torque, but we're going to see our peak torque, which has been staying at about 9.5, is going to increase. Now our peak torque is at 10.75. But notice how our clamp torque stayed at 5. That one even closer to 11, but consistent clamp torque. Very consistent clamp torque. That one was at 11. If you'd like more information on this product, we're using the MT Focus 6000 controller here. You can go to the link in the description and pick one up for yourself. If you'd like to see more videos like this in the future, please subscribe and sign up for the notifications so that you always know when our next video is popping up. Thank you for watching, and as always, have a good day.